Sherry and Ricky Bedillion look at their backyard and feel
very disgusted.
Yeah, disappointment, anger, you know, embarrassed. I mean, we've had, you know, neighbors constantly asking us, what's going on with your deck?
Here's what's going on. No flooring, only a couple pieces of railing. The weeds tell the tale.
They got started the end of June of 2019.
They said they probably have it done within 6 to 8 weeks.
Fast forward roughly 14 months later, and the Bedillions receive a voicemail from Matthew Walker. It's August 20th, the same day this Chippewa couple joined the criminal case against the father and son duo, Alexander and Matthew Walker, with Three Rivers Decks and Porches. The voicemail message says, quote, "We're doing everything we can for our customers. I've been on the phone with lawyers and banks all day today. I'm trying to mortgage both of our homes." The Walkers hired this lawyer, defense attorney Sean Logue.
So at no time did they ever take money from somebody and just not show up to do any work.
Logue points to the pandemic, saying it devastated his client's company. The Bedillions say that doesn't add up.
Absolutely ridiculous. You know, I mean, certainly that would apply to people who just had their project begun here in the spring. But for us and many others, it doesn't apply. It's not even a question. It doesn't apply because those projects should have been finished long time ago.
The Bedillions join the Kellys, the Polacks, and the Geyers. Four families, four incomplete jobs, $13,000, $16,000, $28,000, and now $60,000.
Slowly but surely, we've all been kind of discovering each other and finding out that we're all in the same exact boat and pretty much have the same exact story. It's amazing.
The Attorney General's office is keeping track of the complaints. They were at 12 before our story aired. Now they tell me they're up to 16. Logue, the Walkers' defense attorney, says that the Walkers have bonded out of jail. They're working long days to try to get the work done. The AG's office today tells me that it deactivated their registration for the license in early May. Reporting tonight, Meghan Schiller, KDKA News.